this to the list of sort of random moments in your life. A Washington Post reporter sharing the story of his totally unexpected phone conversation with President Trump. Here's the best part. The president seemed rather surprised by it as well. Joining us now, Dan Balz, chief political correspondent from The Washington Post. Dan, great to have you with us.
Thank you, Erica.
So all of this transpired Friday night. You're having dinner in a cafe in Paris, and all of a sudden, someone hands you the phone and says, would you like to talk to the president? Did you think it was a joke?
Well, I didn't know whether it was a joke or exactly what was going on. I mean, it was, you know, it was the last thing you would expect to hear sitting in a restaurant in Paris with another American who I didn't recognize saying, do you want to speak to the president of the United States? And so my first inclination was, well, is he talking about President Macron of France? And then I thought, no, he's an American. And I could see from the telephone the caller ID did not have a name or a number on it. And I thought, White House calls do come in mm-hmm. with that lack of identification. So I said, sure, I'll take the phone. And it turned out to be the president.
It was a good decision on your part because we're all enjoying the story, too, I have to say selfishly. So, you know, as you're talking to the president in the first couple of minutes, he at one point asks you whether you're Hillary or Trump, and that's when you revealed your true identity.
Yeah, I mean, when I originally said hello, I just said, hello, Mr. President. And the fellow who handed me the phone, who turned out to be Joe Kernan from CNBC, who I would recognize watching TV, but I didn't recognize him in a restaurant in Paris.
Sure.
He had been talking to the president because the president had called to express regret that he couldn't do an interview with Mr. Kernan at Davos at the World Economic Summit this week. And Joe apparently said, you know, even here in Paris, everybody's talking about you. There are two gentlemen next to me at the table, and they're talking about you. And the president apparently said, are they still there? Let me speak to them. So Joe didn't recognize me. I don't think he really knows me. And so he thought, you know, just these are two, you know, Americans talking about the president. So he handed me the phone and I said, hello, Mr. President. And, you know, I could instantly tell that it was him. Mm-hmm. His voice was clear. And I thought, well, I'm a reporter. I ought to try to get some news out of him. So I tried to ask him a few questions and I didn't get very far. And that's when he said at one point, are you Hillary or are you Trump? And I said, well, I'm a reporter.
And that sort of stopped him short. It takes a lot for the president to, you know, have a moment of silence like that. But you did kind of stop him short when you said that. You weren't what he was expecting.
No, I think he just thought we were two, you know, sympathetic Americans who were talking about him in Paris. So when I said, I'm a reporter, and there was silence on the other end of the line. And at that point, I think he was probably as, you know, surprised about this telephone call as I had been when I picked up the phone. So then I said to him, Mr. President, do you know who you're speaking with? And he said, no. And I said, it's Dan Balz from the Washington Post. I don't have a real relationship with the president, but I interviewed him a few times during the campaign. So, you know, once that happened, then, you know, it was kind of everybody's cards are on the table.
I love, too, that in the piece that you wrote, you said you tried a couple questions about the shutdown. You wrote that you didn't think your questions are working, that they need some work, and wrote suggestions, Josh, referencing Josh Dossie. Has Josh offered any pointers?
Josh has not, unfortunately. he's keeping his secrets to himself, as I suppose any good, smart reporter would do. They will never reveal the things that really work. But, you know, as you all know, he's one of your contributors, and he's a fabulous reporter and part of our terrific White House team. And he had taken a call from the president, not an unexpected call, but he hadn't gotten much notice. And he got a few things out of the president in that telephone call. So I was thinking, well, geez, I got to do as well as Josh. When I get back to Washington, I'm going to make sure he tells me the secrets.
All right. Well, sounds good. Dan, really appreciate you taking a moment to join us this morning. Thank you.
Thanks, Erica.
I love the false modesty of Dan Balz right there,
right,
who is one of the greatest political reporters in the country, a mentor, I think, to generations of campaign reporters like me there. The idea that Dan could be on the phone with the president not know he's talking to Dan, just ripe with so many possibilities.
Right. It's great. Although, you know, as Dan points out, too, he said, you know, Mr. President, do you know who this is? And then he said, well, I kind of felt bad because then I realized, how would he know at this point? But it's a fun read. So,
not a knock on Josh Dossie, by the way. Josh can teach us all a lot of things, but we've all learned, including Josh, from Dan Balz there. Mm-hmm. What a great story that is.